Over the past couple of days, we've been getting some zombie teasers, leaning pretty heavily into the story of Black Ops Cold War, and signifying that we're going to be continuing that story in some way, shape, or form. Just today, we got a full-fledged cinematic that's about 4 minutes in length. I'll put a link in the description below if you'd like to check it out without my commentary, but I gotta tell you, this actually does get me very, very hyped for the story, and more importantly, what's going to be happening with zombies in MW3. The teasers that we've been getting over the past few days have been referencing some of the Requiem members that we had during Cold War. So one thing to keep in mind is we're going to have a gap of history that is uncounted for because Treyarch didn't release their game yet, and they're going to be going back in time from all the leaks that we've seen. They're going to be going to the 90s. So leading up to what is actually happening in this cutscene, it's basically picking up right after what we're going to be seeing for Treyarch's next game. As these soldiers make their way into this mysterious bunker, they come to a table with a mysterious device in the middle. This table has some of our Requiem members, including Weaver, which seems to be deceased at this point, but not in a conventional way. I want to point that out. It almost seems like they needed to do some sort of ritual in order to have this device sealed on the table. Why else would they be there and stay there for so long? It really is one of those confusing mysteries that we're not really going to know about until Treyarch's next game comes out. At least that's what I'm assuming. It almost looks like all of these people sitting at the table had their life force sucked out of them, maybe to seal this container, but then it's opened up pretty easily by this mysterious soldier, and it isn't until the mask is removed that we realize this is Viktor Zakhaev. Zakhaev, the same one that was thrown off of an active missile silo during the Verdansk events, has somehow survived that, I don't know, maybe it was a 150-foot drop, 200 feet, I don't know, but he survived it. He landed on what I'm assuming is concrete, or maybe there was something down below that cushioned the blow, but you can definitely see he's much worse for wear. But he doesn't care, he's still alive, and now he's got the vials of Ethereum. In the machine itself, it also looks like there's a spot for two more vials, but there was only two available instead of four. I don't know if this is going to play a critical role in the full game, like maybe we need to find four packs or two packs of this Ethereum and bring it back to base. I think that would be an interesting situation. But overall, this one just had two, and one of those vials ends up getting utilized to create the newest outbreak, unfortunately. Zakhaev goes ahead and then throws the vial, and it smashes open, and it creates a whole bunch of new zombies that are just bloodthirsty and ready to take you down. Now, within this situation, too, I am curious if that means the Requiem agents that were underground, are they now coming back to life as well? Like, can we go and play this and find Weaver? Kind of similar to, like, Ronald Raygun. He'll randomly pop up from time to time and drop a Raygun when you take him down. I think that's pretty cool. But as the cutscene continues, we see this outbreak start to begin, and Zakhaev ends up actually escaping with a person by the name of Jack Fletcher. He is the owner of Terminus Outcomes, the PMC group that will be working alongside Zakhaev. And as long as they're making money, no job is too crazy, even when it comes to the zombie outbreak. So, in comes the good guys. We have Kate Laswell and, of course, Soap McTavish teaming up with someone that I was not expecting to see, but Ravenov is back. And since this is, of course, in the future, he's much older, he's much more rugged, and you can see that that's reflected here, but he's the only one that has a grasp on what happened in the past with the outbreak, and the only one that can really direct this new objective, which is Operation Deadbolt. That means nothing gets in, nothing gets out, pure containment, and that's what they're trying to do, just like in the past when it came to Outbreak. Apparently, Laswell has had information about Zakhaev for a few months, but they weren't exactly sure what he was planning. But the 141 team and, of course, Ravenov are about to find out as soon as they get boots on the ground. So not only are we going to be going up against zombies, but in this iteration of zombies, we're also going to be going up against enemy AI in the form of Jack Fletcher's group, Terminus Outcomes. And once we are in game, I guess we can just imagine DMZ enemies have weapons. It's going to kind of be the same thing with vehicles. But the blog post lets us know that we're going to be embarking on difficult and multi-stage tasks as Soap and Company, as we attempt to stop Zakayev and Terminus from plundering more resources, all while attempting to contain the current threat before it spreads out of control. They go on to mention that we're going to be containing the incursions across different regions that escalate in difficulty, with core zombie features and a cavalcade of secrets to discover. We can ready up for an open-world player versus environment extraction survival experience shared with other squads, other actual players, but we won't be doing PvP this time around. It's just going to be PvE, and we can work together with real players that are on the world. That's something that I've been asking for, a mode like that, for such a long time in DMZ. So personally speaking, as a solo player, not really wanting to go up against constant six-man teams, I'm excited for this. I'm very much so looking forward to playing this. They also mentioned that they're combining the very best of Modern Warfare's map features and systems with the tried and true core features that we've always come to know and love in Treyarch Zombies. We're going to be having specific special story missions. There's also going to be a variety of unique elements, challenges, as well as cinematics to reinforce the major story developments. So I've been saying this throughout the entire reveal portion of Modern Warfare 3, but that is, keep expectations in check. You know, it's okay to be excited, and it's okay to look forward to certain things, but I'm definitely keeping my expectations in check. I'm really, really hoping that Sledgehammer can pull that magical rabbit out of a hat and bring us a really cool experience. And so far, what we've been able to see, I think that they're trying to do the best that they possibly can in the time that they were allotted. Now, at the end of this particular trailer, it gives us our very first look at an upcoming pre-order bonus called Zombie Ghost. This new pre-order bonus is available instantly to all of those who digitally pre-ordered Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3. There is no other way to get it. You have to digitally pre-order this game in order to get Zombie Ghost. If you do it before Season 6, your Zombie Ghost will be available on September 27th. If you pre-order after September 27th, Zombie Ghost will be available for you to use immediately. This skin will also carry forward into MW3, it can be used in Warzone, and of course, Modern Warfare 2 multiplayer. So the last thing I want to talk about in this video is unfortunately something that I cannot show, most likely, without getting a copyright strike, and that is the leaked artwork for Season 6 of Modern Warfare 2, which we know will be the Halloween-like season with the haunting returning. The character that is in the artwork is none other than Spawn, which I think is badass, but at the same time, very suiting for what's going to be happening with the haunting event. I do like the idea of having a Halloween themed season, and it definitely seems like they're going that route, especially by putting Spawn as the main character artwork for the season itself. That could very well change when Season 6 Reloaded comes around, but as of right now, I think that's a pretty cool thing, and I am looking forward to seeing what they're going to be doing with the haunting this year. Hopefully it is a full-fledged event and not just a series of bundles that you can purchase like the boys event was, kind of. But yeah, anyway, that's it. Thank you guys for watching. I appreciate you coming down to this video. If you enjoyed, drop a like, subscribe for more, and I will see you all on the next one. Peace.